welcome you all on behalf of BSE Focus Forum. As part of our forum's activity, every time we are conducting seminars, recent seminars we conducted was on CKYC, not only here but pan-India, where members attended in very large numbers. Just to give you a gist, here when we had conducted, more than 600 members had participated. In Delhi, 150 plus members had come. In Kolkata, the number was 200, Ahmedabad 180. So this is part of our series to ensure that member gets more knowledge towards compliance, operations and other things. Today we have two speakers in today's seminar. The first speaker is Mr. Rajesh Ranjan, General Manager and Head Fixed Income and Derivatives. He will be explaining about his new products for 15-20 minutes. And after that we have Ms. Hita Shah from the Compliance Department to give us an update on the latest compliance issues faced by our members. So without taking much of your time, I would request Sri Rajesh to please come and share his presentation.
Good evening. Day before yesterday we launched clean price trading mechanism on BSE debt trading platform. Actually, if you look at the debt market in India, it is divided into two segments. One is government security, which is generally called the G-Sex, another is corporate bonds. So far G-Sex are concerned, it is normally issued by central government as well as various state governments. And so far bonds are concerned, it is normally issued by FI, financial institution bond, PSU bonds and corporate bonds. What happens earlier, the trading used to be on dirty price mechanism. In dirty price mechanism, accrued interest is already embedded in it. Actually, when you do a bond pricing on purely on theoretical basis, what happens, you take the coupon rate and derive at the price by ongoing market yield. So what happens if there is no change in yield, then the clean price should be same, but as days go by, the accrued interest will increase day by day. So there was no transparency in the price mechanism. Because I'm taking the another point. Suppose yield goes up, naturally your value of the price of the bond goes down. But due to increased accrued interest, it may not reflect. So to bring transparency, we have introduced the clean price mechanism. And it is in line with the debt OTC market. Because if you look at the OTC market, it is trade are always done on clean price market. So with our new trading platform, we have moved to 42 corporate bonds and 87 G-Sex in clean price mechanism, in which the trading will be done on clean price mechanism and settlement will be done on dirty price. Because in settlement, the seller should get the accrued interest till that day. And in debt OTC market, the price of the bond is always expressed in 100 basis point. So we have moved to 100 basis point from suppose a bond has a face value of 1000. But when you do trading on clean price mechanism, it will be quoted in 100. But when once you put the order in the system, it will show the dirty price, and dirty price at that time it will be converted into multiple of face value. Actually, it will be aligned with the face value. Earlier we had only two groups. One was A group for corporate bond and G group for G-Sex. Now we have four groups. The additional two groups are FC and GC. C stands for clean. Apart from that, in our new trading platform, we have provided 50 new fields which gives information about everything related to that bond. Even we have taken the cash flow of all those bonds which have moved to clean price mechanism, and based on that cash flow, dirty price is being calculated. and rolling settlement will be done on T plus 2 basis, and it is backed by the settlement guarantee fund of ICA. So far, number of participants registered on our bond trading platform, it is 1,350 plus, and number of securities available on our bond trading platform, it is 4,000 plus. So we have moved only fraction of total security available to clean price marketing. Gradually, we will move more security on that platform. So far, retail trading in corporate bonds are concerned. During last quarter, we have 76.67 market share. Even today is the third day of launching our clean price mechanism. We have maintained more than 60% market share. The key features of clean price mechanism mean that a trader can place order on a bond based on clean price or yield. Even you put yield, it will throw the clean price as well dirty price. Even you put the clean price, it will throw yield and dirty price. So what happens whenever you place an order, the exchange will compute yield if you have put the clean price, or it will compute the clean price if you have entered the yield. Because most of the day traders take view on the yield, where interest rate market will move. When there is perception that interest rate, RBI may cut interest rate in future, naturally yield goes down. If other external factors are there, is no change in other external factors. So most of the trading views is taken on the basis of yield, movement in yield. And in this price mechanism, every order will be matched on clean price mechanism. Along with, in this new trading platform, it will give you white yield. If the bond has the call or put option, it will give you YTP, yield to put, or YTC also. And even on, when you are going to use this trading platform, you will get 50 key details of that bond, that is issue date, maturity date, interest payment dates, record dates, ratings, everything you will find in description. Even in rating thing, you will find previous two or three ratings. And we have made all information available on our website also. We have placed our booklet on this thing on our BSE website. Apart from that, I have shared the booklet and brochure with the BSE Brokers Forum. Now, the question is, what are the advantages of clean price or yield-based trading? If you look at the global market, most of the global market, particularly in bond market, they used to trade on clean price mechanism, and settlement is done on dirty price mechanism. So we are bringing our system in line with the global market and global practices, and it will be in line with our OTC market and NDSO on which GSEC trading is done, and it will bring uniformity in pricing also. Apart from that, we are giving you huge amount of information from our bond database. Because if you capture more around 50 important fields from a bond, you will get all type of data so far risk is concerned about that company or that issues. And for equity, the members who have got equity membership, there is no separate membership required, and it provides access to all our existing equity members. There is no need for maintaining a separate collateral for trading, and there is no need for separate demat account or bank account to be maintained. And right now, it is connected through our old TWL and IML vendor, but some of IML vendors have not developed the product. Although we have given them our requirement on 1st June, but they are in the process of modifying, they are in the process of bringing all the required changes. but it is already available on old TWS platform. And so far as specifications are concerned, for private placement lots, private placement bonds, the market lot will be trade value of 5 crore divided by face value of the bond. For retail lot, it will be trade value of 10 lakhs divided by the face value of the bond. So far public issued bond are concerned, the market lot side will be trade value of 5 crore divided by the face value of the bond. And for retail lot, it will be lot side will be equivalent to 1 bond. So far government bond are concerned, lot size will be equal to 10 bonds and market lot will be trade value of rupees 5 crore divided by face value of the bond. So far available securities are concerned, we will publish the list of securities from time to time basis. Whenever we move more securities to clean price measuring, we will publish the circular also regarding this effect. And we have already made two groups, that is FC for corporate bond and GC for government bond on clean price mechanism. So far, order matching is concerned, it will continue to match on the basis of existing price time priority with clean price quoted in 4 decimals. And so far, tick size is concerned, in FC group, tick size will be 0.0001 paise. And in case of government bond, it will be quarter price. Close price will be same as it was earlier. And settlement will be on T+2 deal basis. Thank you. Any questions?
Friends, we will share the presentation given by Mr. Rajesh through our Google group. Now I request Ms. Shastra to come here and share the presentation on the compliance.
From BSC Brokers Supervision Department. We'll be talking about the common non-compliances we find during the internal audit reports or the inspections we conduct. And we'll try to give you the procedures and processes by which you can overcome that. For that, actually, we did the analysis of the internal audit reports which you submit half yearly. We did the analysis for the last 2 years and we found that in certain areas the violations are maximum. Like on the screen you see there are trading terminal operation systems. There we found the maximum non-compliances by maximum number of brokers. Then dealing with the client's funds, securities, then compliance status of last inspection report of exchanges, SEBI, internal auditor. See, whenever there is any qualification, any non-compliance observed by any third party, that is an alert to you that your system is going wrong here. That is a ready-made alert to you. So how to rectify that? First of all these reports should be reported to your highest management. Then you have to sort out the processes, the systems to rectify that. Then we found the client registration processes and documents, the maximum non-compliances were there. Then regarding PMLA, contract notes, statement of accounts, client margin details, order management, and so on. This is the graphical presentation. You will find trading terminal operation and system is the bar is the highest one. Now in trading operations and system, what were the exactly non-compliances? That was certification 3A, NSM certification 3A. And what is that? Compliance officer qualification. So your compliance officer should have the NSM series 3A certification. That is must. After 2015, March 2015. So most of the brokers fail to provide their certification to the internal auditor, that's why this non-compliance was there. The simple solution to this is that you ask your compliance officer to pass this certification. Are you hire a compliance officer with this certification already? Then NSM CD 7, that is required for all your sales personnel who is handling your investors' assets, clients' assets, investor services. See, for that, I think last year there was one circular that if the one senior person is having that certification, the other stop doing the administrative work and reporting to them. That is perfectly all right. You can devise one policy approved by your board and then you can give at a time of inspection. So at least one leader should have that certification. So there is no penalty on this. We just advise, but still, if you want to remove that non-compliance to be observed during various reports, this is the easy mechanism. Then there was regarding dealing with client funds and securities. The trading member has not done the actual settlement. In the coming slides, we will show you actually the format of settlement is much broader. It is not that if the client is having 1 lakh rupees credit balance, you have to just give it back. It is not so. You can retain 225% of the margin obligations as on T day, the day of which you are considering as the settlement day. You can deduct the gross turnover in cash segment. You can deduct the paying obligations of T day. You can also deduct the deduction of T minus 1 day. So all these, after deducting all these, whatever is left in the funding client ledger balance, that you have to refer. Apart from that, whatever securities are there in client beneficiary account, you have to value for that. You have to put the haircut on that. And after that, the retention amount which you are allowed to retain. If the retention is more than your client ledger balance, then up to that extent, even the securities you can hold, and the balance securities, if any, should move from client beneficiary account to the individual client BO account. That should happen at least once in quarter or 90 days. And the date of settlement is up to you. You have to mention to us that on this date, you are done the settlement. Even the debit balance within 90 days or zero balance of the client for funds purpose, you can mention it is a settlement. But you should have sent the statement of account to the client with retention details, and we will verify that on sample basis. So you should be ready with that. So while you are doing the settlement and considering that, you should take the conscious decision that this particular was the settlement date, and you have to provide the supporting documents for that date. Once you do that, this should not come actually, if you are genuinely doing the settlement. But we find many brokers don't submit only the statement. We will come to that statement. we will explain in detail. Second is the trading member has seen the statement of accounts. Again, within 7 days of the settlement, the broker is supposed to send the statement with retention details and all that, so that the client comes to know whether his account is settled and if what are the retentions if any. This I already mentioned that apart from that, client 10,000 amount you need not settle provided it is not the inactive. If it is inactive, you have to settle that also. Just refund him 10,000 and you are over, your job is over. But if the client is having the balance more than that, you can retain up to 10,000 apart from what I mentioned earlier. Share the format during the inspection also. So we'll make the them, I think. That is not opening here. We'll go to the next this thing. Client registration documents. In that we found that while uploading the KYC, the brokers have not stick to the requirement of uploading the KYC on KRA. That is the easiest thing one can do, but somehow the non-compliance are there. Then the financial details are required to be reviewed and updated regularly, particularly for the clients dealing, trading in derivative segment that brokers are not doing. Maybe due to lack of knowledge, otherwise corresponding with the clients and taking the financial details should not be that non-compliant. Then regarding systems pertaining to PMLA, we found that members have not registered through FIU gateway. Then contract notes are not sent in the prescribed format. In the letter, one slide we show that ISN number is to be mentioned now. With our latest circular on contract notes, ISN number has to be mentioned somewhere in the contract note below the name of the scripts. In the bracket also you mentioned, you need not have a separate column. The ISN number has to be mentioned. Then on under order management and risk management system of the internal audit report, member has correctly reported details of client funding, if any, to the AC. This is a monthly requirement of client funding. If you are funding to the clients, you have to just report. It is not on how much and whether less or more. But if the client funding is there, the format is there on the day during the month, the highest client funding is there, you have to give the breakup on account of settlement obligations, pain obligations, margin obligations. You have to just report that. So if the broker is not doing that monthly reporting, this non-compliance will come in the internal audit report. Plus, if you are not doing the client funding, very important, if you are not doing the client funding, you have to submit one bill undertaking, which says that you are not doing any client funding. That undertaking will remain till you revoke that. If you are doing some client funding in a particular month, you have to revoke that and upload the client funding details, that's all. Every month we are issuing a notice on client funding. You have to see that. Within a week you have to report the client funding. Then during inspection also almost similar non-compliance we found. You see the funds is on the highest bar. That is the settlement of funds. Then books of accounts, of course we are not charging the penalty for the minor books, but if it is client ledger, you are not maintained, you are not shown the ASCII, bank statement, bank book and all that, that is a major violation, we are charging also a huge penalty on that. Then client registration documents, again that was the common with the internal audit report non-compliances. The statement to accounts, the common contact note, the common thing. Trading terminal. Now, trading terminal you can give only to the sub brokers, authorized persons. If you for giving your terminal to the client for trading for others. That will be the non-compliance, and we are charging the highest penalty of ₹50,000 per such terminal. Then again, the PMLA requirement we already covered. Investor grievances. Investor grievance, you have to deal with very carefully, particularly unauthorized trading, non-receipt of funds, settlements. Now you are supposed to actually settle the funds and securities once in 90 days or a quarter. If some client is demanding you the settlement in between, or if you have missed the settlement and the particular client wants the settlement, and still if you are not able to settle, then definitely this is something wrong with your financial liquidity. So you have to tackle your investor grievances very carefully, and if you are really genuine, very serious, you have to sort out, solve, close at the exchange level before it is being noted by the internal auditor or third party inspector. Then client code and PAN. Nobody can trade for a client who doesn't have the PAN, or you cannot trade on behalf of the client for whom you are not uploaded the PAN number. Not only the PAN number should be inserted, but that should be correct also. From the income tax website and all that, you have to verify that. Then only the correct PAN number you have to upload. If you are not doing that, again there will be a non-compliance, and there is a penalty, huge penalty for that, which is 10,000 per day. Then securities, the same thing, non-settlement of securities. Then intermediary is dealing. If you are dealing with some unauthorized person who is neither your AP nor your sub-broker, then again we are charging ₹1 lakh penalty per such intermediary. Then there will be miscellaneous non-compliances. Now regarding client funds and securities, we are finding generally the non-compliances regarding, in case of running account, actual settlement of funds is not done. Then authorization from the clients. Some brokers say that we have taken the authorization from the client, that settlement has not to be done. You cannot take this authorization. Even if some client authorizes you, that is not valid. You have to do settlement once in a quarter or 90 days, whether the client wants or not. If the application or the obligation lies on the broker. Then at the time of actual settlement, one has to send the statement of account, we already covered. Then there should be one error reporting clause in the statement of account, that within 7 days the client has to come back in case of any error he finds. If he doesn't come back, it will be considered by the broker that whatever is sent to him is correct. That clause is very important to protect yourself. So that clause is mandatory also. Then at the time of actual settlement, you cannot enter edges the different accounts, related party accounts, family accounts. At the time of margin in one of the circular, it is allowed, but at the time of settlement that is not allowed so far. In case the member issues the check and says that he has done settlement, we are also clever enough, we check the bank statement to see whether actually the funds have moved from your account to the client account. So till the check is clear, you cannot say that the settlement is done. Then actual settlement is not applicable to the institutional clients settling trades through the custodian. After completing all these common things, We will touch upon the recent compliance requirements. Like risk-based supervision, we have issued the penalty norms. And regarding NISM certification, one combined certification was allowed. Regarding contract note ISN, and then Aadhaar-based eKYC process, and very recent central KYC, all these circulars have been issued recently. Regarding risk-based supervision, we just married to the process. Certain data fields are available with the exchanges, and certain data fields are taken from the very few data fields as compared to the data fields available with the exchange are collected from the brokers on half-yearly basis as of now. After collating the data from the brokers and exchanges, we assign the risk. After assigning the risk, we assign the impact rating. Then by multiplying both the risks, we get the supervisory ratio. And based on the highest risk ratings, we are conducting the inspections also. This is also one of the criteria. On the basis of the data fields, we arrange the data in the ascending order. Suppose one broker has the lowest number of non-compliances, he will be on the top. And another broker has the highest number of non-compliances as one of the data fields on which we have to assign the risk. That broker will be at the last row. Then the brokers lying on the first 25% of the rows will be assigned as quartile 1. The next 25% of the rows will be assigned quartile 2. Then third 25% of the data fields or rows will be assigned quartile 3, and the remaining quarter will be quartile 4. Now quartile 1 brokers are the lowest risk. Then second quartile is the medium, and the at the lowest row lying in the quartile 4 are the highest risk brokers.
How do you define financials of this broker?
Financial soundness? No. Okay. There are certain data fields. Suppose we have the debit balances of your clients. Okay, and whether you are doing the settlement, then what are your collaterals available with the exchange and clearing operations?
And suppose I go in the very lowest category, I can TGC. Is it so?
If you are in the lowest risk category, we may not do the inspection under this criteria. See, there are various, yeah,
once a three. So, can I
know
where do I stand after my inspection?
Check.
Where do you stand after inspection?
Which four categories I stand in? In your reports.
Okay. That will give you after this thing. Right now, I don't have the data.
I believe that will be
confidential.
That's what I'm asking. Is it confident or can I know that? See, if you are doing the inspection on the highest risk, definitely you will ask the question. But if you are not coming in the inspection, probably you will not come to know. Then if the broker is not submitting the details as of now at all, then also we will be conducting the inspection. Rather, we are conducting the inspection. Not only that, we are charging the penalty also for the period or the year ended March 2016. Whoever has not submitted the data within the due date, we are charging the penalty also. The penalty norms, we issue the circular also. I'll just define. The due date was given 61 days after the 8th of March, that was 31st May. If somebody submitted the data within that date, no penalty. If somebody submitted the data within 5 days of the due date, the penalty was 10,000. Further 10 days, the penalty will be 10,000. Plus 2,000 per day. Then further 30 days, There was no submissions like this, but if it happens in future, the broker will not be able to register the new plans. Plus, highest risk rating will be given to that person. Then even after further 30 days, if the broker doesn't submit the data, then his terminal will be deactivated and highest risk rating will be given. Now recently one circular was issued on series 13 for derivative segment, otherwise different certifications were required to be passed. Like for currency derivatives it was series 1, interest rate derivatives it was series 4, and for equity derivatives it was 8. But in February 2015 one circular came from SEBI that series 13 can be passed and all these three individual certifications were not required. So if you are passing series 13, that will be sufficient for all derivative segments. Just some time back I explained that ISIN number is required now. Then recently on Aadhaar-based eKYC, SEBI issued the circular that if you are doing the KYC based on Aadhaar, then even IPV is not required if you are doing KYC through biometric instrument. Now central KYC, very recently SEBI has issued the circular that the broker has to upload individual clients KYC on central KYC website. For that first he has to register on that and get the login credentials. He will have administrator user ID, maker checker user ID, and within 3 days of client registration he has to upload that, and the KYC form will be uniform. So whatever was the earlier KYC form as per August 2011 circular, that is replaced for the individual client with this format. So these are the basic non-compliance reform and the recent
So everyone try to be on the safe contact. There is one more topic I just wanted to update you about on FATCA. I just come from a SEBI meeting where officials of CBDT were there. Bhul gaya isko? Nahi to main mein dekhenge. As per the income tax rules, all the accounts that are opened between June 14 and August June 2014 to August 2015, we are supposed to take self-certification from the clients. He has nothing to do with USA. If self-certification is not taken, you are supposed to close the accounts by 31st August 2015. Kisko yaad tha? Chalo, ek mic laal hai. So we just had a meeting with SEBI. These rules are written by SEBI. It's also knowledge for you. The rules just came from there. The rules are written by CBDT and the Income Tax Department. And they had called the banks, mutual funds, because mostly khate bandh hoge Indians ke. Right? Most of clients are Indians. So, we have requested for extension so that they will take the matter to their board, the board will take the matter, then to the FM. The FM will take the matter to US government. And if US government agrees, then we get extension after 31st August. If it doesn't agree, toh kya? 31st August, we have to close all the accounts. Now again, for those members who are individual, sole proprietary firm, unpe FATCA obligations lagta hi nahi hai.
आप दिमाग मत लगाओ, बट ऑल द नॉन दोज बाकी जितने भी नॉन कॉप नॉन इंडिविजुअल्स हैं, सो यू गाइस प्लीज नेक्स्ट 15 डेज में सारे क्लाइंटों को वापस अप्रोच करो कि भाई साहब प्लीज़ गिव मी अ वन लाइन लेटर कि आउट इंडिया के अलावा किसी भी अदर कंट्री में मेरा कोई टैक्स रजिस्ट्रेशन नहीं है. Just a one-line letter, even anything. Ideally, it should be a letter signed by the client. But please get a confirmation. Otherwise, you're supposed to close his account. Close. There's no other word. We have requested close this, sir. Freeze allow kar do, sariya allow kar do. Khub, jo bhi maan sakte the, maan liye. But the law is 31st August. Favorite question: Law break kiya to kya hoga? Income tax ki penalty lagegi. उसके अलावा आपका अकाउंट यू विल बी रिपोर्टेड एज अ गड़बड़ फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन टू यूएसए. नाउ यू शुड नो अमेरिकन्स डोंट फॉरगेट. एक बार के सिस्टम में गया तो देन आर ब्रोकिंग एंटिटी इज ऑलवेज अ रेड फ्लैग इन द सिस्टम. क्या फर्क पड़ता है यूएसए से मेरा क्लाइंट है कि बट बस अमेरिकन से उसको पता भी डायरेक्टर कौन है. यूएस घूमने जाओगे सिस्टम में बीप बीप करने लग जाएगा. ओके थोड़ा ज्यादा हो गया बट पॉइंट इज अगेन एज फॉरम एक ही चीज बोलते हैं टू टाइप्स ऑफ नॉन कंप्लायंसेस. एक जो जानबूझे कानून तोड़ते नहीं करते सेटल जाओ 50,000 पेनल्टी ना कोई बात नहीं दे देंगे. इनका भगवान ही मालिक है कुछ नहीं कर सकता कोई. लेकिन कई होता ना यार पता होता तो मैं कर देता लेटर मंगाना है सेल्फ मंगा लूंगा कोई बोला ही नहीं है. So please get all the paper, please get your files in order. Right now the exchanges are not checking, but in 2019 there will be a SEBI inspection who will say, "Hey, 2016 mein aaya tha, please give us what are the steps that you took." Abhi right now in the last 10 days, three brokers have approached me that SEBI ka inspection aaya hai. Oh, you have mota mota. Anybody here who's got a recent SEBI inspection? होगा तो बताओगे नहीं. बट इट्स रूटीन. अगेन उनका भी कोई ऐसे कोई मैट्रिक्स होगा ये खतरनाक 25% चलो क्या चलते थीम कैसे मैं कॉम्प्रेंस. सो प्लीज गेट दिस सेल्फ सर्टिफिकेशन ऑर्डर फॉर ऑल अकाउंट्स ओपन आफ्टर 1 July 2014 टिल 31st August 2015. उसके बाद क्या अकाउंट आ गया बट मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि आज की तारीख में भी सारे मेंबर्स का केवाईसी फॉर्म लूंगा तो सेल्फ सर्टिफिकेशन आज की तारीख में भी नहीं ले रहे. यदि ऐसा है तो बड़ी चिंता की बात है. प्लीज चेंज योर केवाईसी फॉर्म से गेट दिस इन ऑर्डर. सो व्हेन आई सॉ सिक्स पॉइंट्स व्हेन यू पुट एज 5 पॉइंट्स इन द 6 पॉइंट. नाउ कमिंग टू दिस. In fact, we have requested CBDT to repeat the offices in World Seminar. Abhi meeting mein to haan bol diye. If we can manage to get them, we'll get them. Again, the topic of seminar will be closure of all the accounts on 31st August 2015. So, jaise log padhi ho, account close nahi seminar mein chalte kuch aaya nahi hai. You see, KYC, the CB issue circular, aap kuch aaya na chodo. नोटिस आया कि बस सिस्टम चेंज हो गया. अच्छा चेंज हो गया तो हेवन से प्लीज रीड द सर्कुलर प्लीज रीड दिस रेगुलेशन प्लीज रीड एटलीस्ट गूगल ग्रुप में इसमें सब डालते हैं. सो विल होल्ड सेमिनार्स विल कॉल सीबीडीटी गाइस प्लीज आना समझ लेना क्या है नहीं आओगे तो आपकी हिम्मत. ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्लाइड आई वाज रीडिंग बस सिर पकड़ने का मन करता है. If members are making such basic mistakes that you pointed out, it's really, really sad. And I think most of it comes out of ignorance or I don't care attitude. Dono nahi chalega. The point is, if internal auditor marks a remark ki tera non-compliance hai, kahin note hota hai. Then exchange marks another remark, kahin non-compliance hai, note hota hai. Ye sare note ek SEBI ke paas jaati hai. आई एम श्योर दीज आर वन ऑफ द फैक्टर्स विच डिटरमाइन सेबी इंस्पेक्शन करने भेजोगे नहीं. जब एक्सचेंज आता है तो लाख दो लाख पांच लाख में फ्लट जाओगे ठीक है. एंड एक्सचेंज इज फिर लिटिल प्रैक्टिकल दे अंडरस्टैंड एज लॉन्ग एज किसी क्लाइंट के साथ नहीं हुआ सो प्रोसीजर लैब्स So they take at least a gentle view, though again they are bound by SEBI regulations, they have to be strict. But then SEBI comes, वहाँ कोई आपको कोई माफी तो सीधा एडजुडिकेशन होगा लाख 25 लाख 50 लाख इज्जत का फलोदा सो अलग ले लाइन ही छोड़ देना है सब बोलेंगे कोई छोड़ता नहीं है श्री बचाने वाला किसी काम के लायक नहीं है एनीवेज क्वार्टरली सेटलमेंट इज अ बिग थिंग दैट सेबी हैज टेकन अप बिकॉज दो तीन रुपये उठ गए कुछ एक दिल्ली का एक कंप्यूटर का पता नहीं कहाँ का दो दिल्ली के Which regions? बॉम्बे वाले कोई नहीं उठा करते वेस्टर्न रीजन है बिकॉज अच्छे लोग हैं बट क्वार्टरली सेटलमेंट इज खत्म क्वार्टर में एक बार खाता निल करना है यार यू हैव टू डू इट मोस्ट बैक ऑफिस ऑफिस नाउ हैव दोज ऑप्शंस प्लीज रन दोज ऑप्शंस सी इफ इट्स नॉट वर्किंग कंप्लायंस गाइस प्लीज टेक पे अटेंशन देयर आर मेनी शॉर्टकट्स देयर आर मेनी चीटिंग्स ऑफ डूइंग इट As an exchange, बोले as long as your client permits, I don't care. But do those basic things, liquid fees में लो, client को high volume turnover के तो इसका settle कर दो. Whatever is, it's not tax avoidance, it's tax planning. So whatever you can do, at least be conscious that we can do it. I was just looking at the chart. पहले इतना बड़ा बड़ा chart भी छोटा हो. 1050 inspections. 2014-15 में inspection was compulsory. 100% इंस्पेक्शन सबका हुआ है उसके बाद से वन थर्ड ईयर रूल हुआ था 236 इस साल पिछले साल में 236 हुआ तो जो पिछले साल में हुआ शायद इस साल वो रिलैक्स हो जाएगा उसके यहाँ नहीं आए अनलेस यू हिट वन ऑफ दोस क्वार्टाइल्स या रैंडम में तुम्हारा नंबर लग गया और इंस्पेक्शन आएगा तभी सुधरेंगे ये तो उचित नहीं है सो दैट्स दैट बाकी क्यू एन मोस्ट वेलकम व्हाटएवर वी आर जो ब्रोकर इंडिविजुअल है
ओके
जैसे
या दे मेड इट क्लियर इंडिविजुअल ब्रोकर
कॉर्पोरेट ब्रोकर इज इंडिविजुअल तो उसपे फटका नहीं लगता
The second point is one liner you said, and there is also a sample given in CBDT. So CBDT sample नहीं चाहिए अपन one liner is okay.
It's a model. अभी CBDT के जो main हैं उनके साथ बड़ा just a model. If you read the CBDT का पूरा format, उसमें लिखा है yes no if yes tuck 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 tuck. यदि no तो tuck 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 है नहीं, तो पूरे डब्बे वब्बे बीच के उड़ा सकते हो. फिर मेरे KYC form में तो बस मेरा इंडिया के अलावा किसी ने दिया नहीं.
सर नॉन डेटेड चलेगा या डेट भी डलवानी
सर इट शुड बी डेटेड इन केस ऑफ अकाउंट्स ओपन बिटवीन
जुलाई
2015 से अगस्त 2015 इट द लेटर शुड बी इन योर रिकॉर्ड बिफोर 31st August फिर क्या बोला मैंने नहीं नहीं जो 14 मंथ्स
क्या
वो जो 14 मंथ्स का पीरियड है जून 2014 से अगस्त 2015 ये जो 14 महीने का पीरियड है इन इसमें जो भी क्लाइंट ओपन हुए क्लाइंट ओपन यूसीसी ओपनिंग डेट स्टैंडर्ड रूल ऑफ थंब या डीमैट अकाउंट ओपनिंग डेट उन क्लाइंट्स का लेटर आप 31st August 2016 तक आपके फाइल पर होना चाहिए जो क्लाइंट 1 सितंबर से खुला और अकाउंट ओपनिंग के टाइम ही आपने लेटर लिया ही होगा और सबके फाइल में पड़ा ही है तो कोई दिक्कत नहीं
है नहीं लिया तो उनसे
सर लिया है सर लिया है जब इंस्पेक्शन टीम आपके ऑफिस में आएगी तो मिलेगा उनको लेटर और डेट ऑफ अकाउंट ओपनिंग का डेट पे लेटर होगा इसका मतलब आपने लिया है
सर नाउ क्यूए अबाउट स्टैंडर्डाइज केवाईसी वी हैव हैविंग लॉट ऑफ पेजेस करंटली डू वी नाउ एज द मैडम वाज सेइंग दैट पर्टिकुलर केवाईसी इज गेटिंग रिप्लेस विद सेंट्रल वाला तो कैन यू गिव द नोटिस नंबर वेयर वन पेजर विल बी रिक्वायर्ड बाय द ब्रोकर्स
In the inspection manual on the BSE website, the notice number is, I think I remember the notice number 2016-0722-8. So 22nd July, this notice was issued, notice number is 8.
So now we have to bother about this notice, this one page here.
This KYC form you are talking
about. Yeah, yeah.
21 जुलाई को सेबी ने एक सर्कुलर इशू किया है, 22 जुलाई को बीएसई ने इन्फॉर्म किया है कि सर्कुलर फॉलो करो। नोटिस किया सेबी का सर्कुलर है सबको,
स्टैंडर्डाइज केवाईसी हो गया ना, एक पेज का वो
एक पेज का नहीं है, सीकेवाईसी का पूरा झमेला है, अभी सबके सब उसी से जूझ रहे हैं, आपको पता नहीं है?
नहीं, वो तो पता है,
बस वही है, वही सीकेवाईसी को स्टैंडर्ड केवाईसी कह लो, न्यू केवाईसी कह लो।
If I'm not mistaken, today's business standard has written something about
it. Sir, in the last 1 week, 3-4 newspapers have carried it. ये भी लिखा है कि 1 अगस्त से सारे broker खाता खोलना बंद कर देंगे, बहुत कुछ लिखा हुआ है. So,
next question is about financial position. We have to take a mandatory from the clients. Now, when we give them the letter, or we can take with the periodical statement which we send, okay, some of them may not be comfortable to give their financial position because you know you also know the reason for it, and we are in the cash segment. How to deal pleasantly with the client?
Sir, there are two things. Ek purana KRA form tha jisme part C tha, jisme income detail manga tha, wo client ko bana zaruri thi. उसके बाद सही बोला पार्ट सी का हटाओ, उसको अंदर पार्ट में पार्ट सी के निकाल के मेक इट अंदर सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द फॉर्म, वहाँ डालना आपको जरूरी है, जिससे सेविंग सर्टिफाइड फॉर्म। जब भी नया अकाउंट आता है क्लाइंट टिक मार देता है, जो मारना दिक्कत आती है जो पुराने क्लाइंट है वो देने को तैयार ही नहीं है, क्या करें, कुछ नहीं कर सकते, आपको लेना पड़ेगा।
विदाउट एविडेंस वी कैन यूज दैट ब्लॉक सिस्टम।
सेल्फ सर्टिफिकेशन इज अलाउड इफ इट इज अ कैश मार्केट क्लाइंट, करेक्ट मी इफ आई एम रॉन्ग। If it's a cash market client, वो बोलेगा मेरा नेटवर्क 100 करोड़ है, ओके एक्सेप्ट कर लो। क्या होता है आजकल तो गांव में जमीन तो होता ही है, और वो बोलेगा इनकम जो भी है यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट इट। इन केस ऑफ डेरिवेटिव्स क्लाइंट आई थिंक यू आर सपोज टू टेक सपोर्टिंग डॉक्यूमेंट्स, और सपोर्टिंग डॉक्यूमेंट्स एक डॉक्यूमेंट इसका नाम है डीमैट अकाउंट स्टेटमेंट। डीमैट में क्या मानते हैं प्राय अब तक सब डीपी भी होते हैं, उसका डीमैट स्टेटमेंट प्रिंट करो अटैच करो, आ गया हर साल का आ गया, और नहीं भी आया तो सिर्फ देन यू हैव टू आस्क फॉर फाइनेंशियल डिटेल्स फॉर इन केस ऑफ क्लाइंट्स वर एक्टिव इन द डेरिवेटिव सेगमेंट।
थैंक यू सर।
दैट्स ऑल।
इवन फॉर डेरिवेटिव सेगमेंट यू हैव टू कीप ऑन रिव्यूइंग आल्सो, यू कैन टेक टैक्स रिटर्न इफ ही इज गिविंग कॉपी ऑफ टैक्स I think the tax return itself will be, you know, may not be showing the income. That's why the IAS scheme is going on, but at least that is the official.
For institutional orders,
I think I will check on that whether the supporting documents are required for cash settlement, but renewal is must for derivatives. That was, but on whether the supporting documents are required for cash settlement, let me come back on that. We'll get back.
You are not required, well, income and network details for cash market is tum chahe lo ya nahi wo bhi option hoga under what exchange regulations, under PMLA act it is a duty to monitor the client's transaction against its financial standing. If you're not taking it, exchange tumko chhod de, FIU tumko nahi chhodega. अरे अपने आप कौन FI इंस्पेक्शन करने आएगा, छोड़ो ना, अभी फटका ला बोले थे अगले साल से हमारा इंस्पेक्शन शुरू हो रहा है, भय भी प्रीत नहीं सर।
आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन ऑन इंस्टीट्यूशनल ऑर्डर्स, आर वी अलाउड टू पुट ऑर्डर्स आफ्टर लाइक मार्केट एज इन पोस्ट क्लोजिंग सेशंस, लाइक इन TWS वी ऑप्शन कॉल्ड एंड ऑफ सेशंस एंड एंड ऑफ डे, सो इन केस सपोज देयर इज अ आफ्टर 3:30 सम क्वांटिटीज लेफ्ट इन इंस्टीट्यूशनल ऑर्डर and the same can get executed in the post closing, are we allowed or it's a part of non-compliance?
No, I didn't. Yeah, you want to transfer the institutional trade?
No, not transfer. The same UCC, there is an order which can get executed in the post closing session at the same price which the order was given to us. So are we allowed?
Why? Why so?
Because there is an option in TWS, end of day or end of session.
I think there is an application process post trading day, otherwise the trading is during the trading session only.
That's what I am saying. Can I get execution of the order in end of day category where there is a, in the TWS there is an option?
May I rephrase the question?
There is an institution order.
Okay. Can an institution trade with postal inspection? Is that a question?
Yeah.
Huh? Why can't he?
He can.
The question you put up.
That's what we need to know. That. Because by mistake he could punch the order on the end of session and it went to end of day. So some of the quantity went in the post closing. So we were just having an issue.
So
the
institution broker confirmed broker something. किसी एनी इंस्टीट्यूशन ब्रोकर या जिसने पोस्ट क्लोजिंग एक इंस्टीट्यूशन का काम किया कर सकते हैं सेल्फ
हेल्प
देयर इज इन आर इन आरबीएस देयर इज अ सिस्टम टू रिपोर्ट इट एक्सचेंज वाइज आरबीएस देयर इज अ सिस्टम टू रिपोर्ट बीएसई इज आस्किंग फॉर द बीएसई डेटर्स क्रेडिटर्स बीएसई बैंक बैलेंसेस एनएससी आस्किंग द एनएससी बैंक बैलेंसेस एनएससी डेटर्स क्रेडिटर्स We have the data in the BSE, the same category created in the NSE. So it is cumbersome, except on the 31st March, we immediately give the debits and credits. So why don't you come out with a simple system of having a broker wise, pan broker wise, instead of giving it exchange wise? So SEBI needs this information. Right now we are segregating the broker. Suppose I am having the 1 crore 20 lakhs debit in the BSE and NSE is having the credit of 19 lakhs. So for BSE 20 lakhs, I have to show him the security of 20 lakhs. For the NSE credit, I have to show the bank balance in the bank. How is it possible?
On certain fields, you will find it is consolidated. But on certain fields, since one exchange say NSE, so definitely the circular issued by BSE has to say that.
Exchange should put this request to the SEBI and make it a single one so that broker should not be suffering. Because you want this system initially within 15 days, okay, you get it extended for 45 days, the second reason. But you need immediately within 15 days of the end of the half year. Mm-hmm. So it's not possible for all the brokers to give you the details such as to make it so fast.
See, whoever is asking the queries, we are telling that if you are not able to segregate, you can give the consolidated, but
we cannot give it consolidated. We will give it consolidated. In the next session, we are going to have the same problems.
No, it's not. We have to be practical.
Okay, you are saying, okay, I agree with you. You are saying, okay, it's okay. But NSE people should also agree, no, for that.
Yeah.
You cannot agree on the same one point singular. Secondly,
ये अभी तो छह महीने का प्रॉब्लम है ना
हाँ अभी
सिक्स ये मंचुरी होने वाला
आप वो इसी का क्वेश्चन आने से नेक्स्ट वन
आई वुड आस्क नेक्स्ट वन एनहांस स्पेस सुपरविजन आएगा ना
व्हेन इज गोइंग टू गेट इंप्लीमेंटेड
होपफुली विद इन अ मंथ
सो आफ्टर दैट उसका इंस्पेक्शन बंद हो जाएगा ना
हाँ
उसका इंस्पेक्शन बंद हो जाएगा
हाँ रेडी पड़ेगा इंस्पेक्शन
कैन यू कॉमन क्लाइंट बैंक अकाउंट फॉर द एनएसी एंड बीएसई ऑपरेशंस कॉमन क्लाइंट बैंक अकाउंट फॉर एनएसी एंड बीएसई ऑपरेशंस
You can have,
is there
and in the back office system, you should have some system to identify, to segregate.
How okay then?
See, you are doing the settlement across the exchanges.
Across the settlement, that is an entirely different thing. Client bank account, can we have NSE and BSE one single account for the NSE and BSE?
See, we are not raising on that, because nowhere it is read, it has to be segregated. So, if you are managing
Can you get this explanation from the SEBI ma'am?
See, SEBI doesn't say that exchange wise you should have
that
separate
SEBI doesn't bank. Know anything, that's not the answer. But what I want to say is you should ask them specifically. They don't reply, I agree with you, ma'am.
मैं बी एस सी एन एस सी क्लाइंट अकाउंट कॉमन रखता हूँ
हाँ जी
तो क्या बी एस सी में प्रॉब्लम है बी एस सी से तो हमें कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं
एन एस सी बोलता है प्रॉब्लम
तो एन एस सी का क्या कंप्लेन से मैंने कौन से बात
सर इसलिए मैं सेबी से मांग रहा हूँ सर
सिस्टम इस सेलर का नाम इसलिए मैंने ऐसा रखा था कॉमन मिस्टेक सीन बाय बी एस सी
Nowadays, common team of the BSC, SEBI and NSE are coming for the inspection.
Only very difficult cases.
किसी
के आया तो बहुत presentation.
One of the point is, can be a common contract.
Can be
common client
contract. Just like
common contract. हमने तो reason ये दिया है कि sir common contract आ गया client को एक bill जाता है, 1,00,000 रुपए का bill बना, वो थोड़ी 50,000 रुपए का दो check देगा. जब वो एक ही चेक देगा तो लॉजिकली एक ही क्लाइंट अकाउंट होना चाहिए. हमने यहाँ तक लिख दिया है. अब व्हाट आई बिलीव इफ समबडी फॉर सम एकेडमिक डिस्कशन, जब कोई ब्रोकर उठता है कि द क्लाइंट हैज 15 लाख रुपीज क्लेम ऑन द आईपीएफ अकाउंट, बट एनएसी, यदि एनएसी का ब्रोकर उठा तो बीएससी आईपीएफ से पैसे मिलेंगे नहीं लॉजिकली, एंड वाइस वर्सा. सो एक्सचेंजेस वॉन्ट सेग्रीगेशन एक्सचेंज राइट्स. जिंदगी में रिंग के जमाने में जाते थे तो बाकी ब्रोकर मिलकर संभालते थे, तो रिक्रिएट करते थे. जब एक बैंक अकाउंट में सब कंफ्यूज है तो ये डिटरमाइन होगा कि इस क्लाइंट को 100 रुपए देना है, लेकिन वो बीएससी की ट्रेडिंग है, एनएससी की ट्रेडिंग है, उसने जो चेक दिया था बीएससी की तरफ से दिया था, कौन सा एक्सचेंज जवाबदार है वो नहीं होता. सो दिस इज द सिद्धांतिक क्वेश्चन दैट मे कम मोस्ट प्रोबब्ली व्हेन सेबी से सवाल पूछेंगे. सेबी को बोलते हैं एक्सचेंजेस क्या करना है क्या नहीं करना है, तो एटलीस्ट द अदर एक्सचेंज इज गोइंग टू से कि फॉर माई एक्सचेंज यू मे हैव वन अकाउंट अक्रॉस सेगमेंट्स. But the exchange should be, but for every exchange there should be a separate client account. That's when I've interacted with them, that is what they have said verbally. But still, as an association, we have to fight with SEBI. How does it matter?
Sir, there is one more question.
Yes.
I might say specifically that if you give a terminal to clients, huge penalties.
Sir, what? Sir?
If you give a terminal to clients, it's a huge penalty.
If you give an IBT terminal to client, there is no penalty.
Sir.
If you give TWS,
क्या फर्क पड़ा सर?
मुझे नहीं पता,
मुझे तो यही नहीं पता आज तक पता चला कि क्या फर्क पड़ा. आईबीटी आपने दे दिया which is having more features than the TWS. क्या फर्क पड़ा सर? Forget the FAO. I'm not talking about the FAO. I'm talking about the NAO or yeah, I'm talking about ODIN. जो भी ODIN से ये जो भी है, all these IBTs are having much more features than what a TWS is having. अगर टर्मिनल पर क्लाइंट बैठ गया उसने कौन सा गुनाह कर दिया, कौन सा पाप कर लिया?
Actually,
और मैंने कौन सा पाप कर लिया सर उसको बैठा के? सर अगर मैं क्लाइंट को बैठाता हूँ तो मेरा प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व हो जाता है सर, कि मेरा कोई जो मिस्टेक हुई क्लाइंट की मिस्टेक हुई, मेरी कोई मिस्टेक नहीं हुई.
I agree with you sir, totally.
IBT के लिए आपको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है.
In fact, this rule came in जब IBT था भी नहीं, तब शायद उनका कोई लॉजिक हुआ क्लाइंट को नहीं बढ़ना
चाहिए. आज भी प्रिवेंट है सर इंडिया में.
सॉरी,
ब्रिटिश एरा का रूल्स तो आज भी प्रिवेंट है और लॉज भी आज भी प्रिवेंट है, लेकिन
फोरम इज रजिस्टर्ड अंडर सोसाइटीज एक्ट 1860. यस सर, दैट्स बहुत सही पॉइंट है, वेरी गुड पॉइंट. सेबी से जब लेंगे तब लेंगे, इवन एज एक्सचेंज यू कुड काइंडली In light of IBT, in light of the established business practice that client को टर्मिनल दिया जाता है, यदि मैंने IBT की तरह किसी client को TWS दे दिया, so please say you should treat, because इसमें कुछ गलत नहीं है. As long as I'm declaring it, I'm not hiding it, please को allow
करना.
Client
बोलता है ना मुझे बैठने दो, मैं बैठूंगा.
इसके अंदर इश्यू ये होगा कि मतलब दोनों साइड का आर्ग्यूमेंट होगा ये कि इन केस ऑफ आईबीटी क्लाइंट्स ही डजंट हैव कंट्रोल ऑन क्लाइंट कोड्स.
इंटरव्यूज
कुछ भी एबीसीडी टाइप का सौदा कर सकता है, गड़बड़ हो जाएगी तो कंट्रोल चाहिए, लॉजिक हो सकता है. बट आई थिंक TWS के नया जो वर्जन आया है उसका ऑप्शन है कि उस टर्मिनल में उस क्लाइंट कोड के अलावा आपके क्लाइंट कोड में डाल ही नहीं सकता. मेरे ख्याल से ये ऑप्शन आ चुका है. In light of the new technological development by TWS,
as long as we have ensured that code is locked with TWS, and if a client is happy with the look and feel of TWS, this should not be taken negatively by the inspection department. That is a suggestion. Okay.
Negatively by the inspection department or no?
Sir?
Not even negatively by the
SEBI
even.
Sir, SEBI
can think
sir,
of
it. Sir, SEBI can think of it.
सिस्टम वेर यू कैन नॉट ट्रेड इन द अकाउंट जिसका यूसीसी नहीं हुआ ऐसा अलग सिस्टम में निकाले क्या करना सर आपका यूसीसी नहीं हो तो क्लाइंट में सौदा क्यों होना चाहिए सर टीडब्ल्यूएस के सिस्टम में ये चीज क्यों नहीं आ सकती जब मेरी ओडी में आ सकती है इसके अंदर आ सकती है स्पेसिफिकली तो कर सकते हैं स्पेंडिंग सो मच मनी
सर टीडब्ल्यूएस में ये आ चुका है सर टीडब्ल्यूएस में ये आ चुका है सर
तो देन
आपने इंप्लीमेंट नहीं किया था ऑफिस में सर ये जब लाया था
टीडब्ल्यूएस में आ चुका है पेनल्टी के सिस्टम से नहीं रहनी चाहिए
क्योंकि आप अपने जो मेंबर्स है ना उन्हें फिर से इंप्लीमेंट नहीं करते उस कोड में सौदा कर लेते हैं जिसमें मैं और यूसीसी यानी मस्ती कर रहा हूँ पॉइंट इज आई टोटली एग्री विथ यू मैं आपसे एग्री कर चुका हूँ क्या चीज
आया तो समय कल आपको कॉल बैक करता हूँ सर मुझे भी
मैं, मेरे ऑफिस में मेरे बैठने को टाइम मैं दो महीने तक मेरे ऑफिस में माता खाया था ये करो वो करो वो करो सब लॉन्च कर दिया ऐसा बताया था मुझे बट अगेन यू हैव अ चॉइस देन यू टू क्रिएट अ फाइल यू टू सेंड
छोड़ो या जो चल रहा है वो चलने के लिए What is client settlement? What is the monthly settlement? What is quarterly settlement? Well, we are doing this one as per your dictates. Dictate, I specially say saying you. There is nothing like client settlement anywhere in the world. You go to any of the Southeast Asian countries, their compliance are something like you just provide the network certificate once in a quarter, that's all.
आप ये कह रहे हो कि क्लाइंट को समझाने के लिए सेमिनार करने चाहिए
सेमिनार नहीं करने चाहिए बीएससी और एनएससी में एक टोल फ्री हेल्पलाइन रखनी चाहिए जो क्लाइंट को बोल रहा था उसको बोले ये लाइन पे फोन करके तो जो क्वेश्चन तो पूछ ले
ठीक है गुड सजेशन इट्स अ गुड सजेशन
डोंट बोदर अस कोई क्लाइंट आज तक पूछता है मुझे मेरी मार्जिन मैंने आपको एक पैसा नहीं दिया मुझे मार्जिन कैसे लगती
सर वेरी गुड सजेशन सर वी विल टेक इट और क्या पॉइंट है
बहुत हो गया सर
See, this is what point is. हर सरना के शुरू में सही बोलता हूँ, मैं बोलता हूँ. Compliance से लेके रोला तो ना बंद कीजिए. ये बंद के भड़ास निकालने की जो प्रक्रिया है.
सर रोला तो ना नहीं है.
अब से
मेरा तो रोला है. मेरा तो इंस्पेक्शन का
रोला है. सेमिनार के बाद मिल के रोएंगे. जो बोलो करेंगे. Implement मतलब point is when last time भी हुआ था when the speaker from BSU or any other person comes, they come as a guest. Okay, they deserve a courtesy. कई बार सभी मतलब जब members सब सब देख रहे हैं खड़े होंगे अल्लाह बचाए शुरू कर देंगे काले देश शुरू कर देंगे पापा से शुरू कर देंगे ऐसा होता है आपने दोस्तों ठीक नहीं आप तो बड़े कवि हैं आपने जो भी बोला
आप सर हमारा तो एक व्यू है कि सर जो भी नए सब जैसे
सजेशन ऐसे
तो क्या नहीं करेंगे क्लाइंट्स आर नॉट इनफॉर्म
ये सब क्या हेडलाइन चला दो ये सब पासवर्ड का मतलब क्या है
सर एक सेकंड
पूरी दुनिया में कहीं
नहीं कोई सर आप इतने सेमिनार बीएससी और एनएससी करते हैं कि यूनिवर्सिटीज के लिए सर करती है कि नहीं करती है This what this be a part of this means this is part of the same thing sir.
But I mean, most of the BSc IPF Sidhna they talk about this. Have you been to any BSc IPF Sidhna?
Sir, मुझे जरूरत नहीं पड़ी ना सर.
Exactly. See, they already talking. All these things are there. But sir, they claim it's for the benefit of the client.
Maybe sir, client को नहीं पता है ना सर. Margins क्या है? जो derivatives में नहीं सोचा करता, उसको margins नहीं पता है सर.
See, it's only one to point. Get into a theoretical discussion. Then it is the duty of the broker. They did an intermediary check. एडुकेट द क्लाइंट तो सर आप प्रेजेंटेशन करो आपने कहा क्लाइंट टर्मिनल हट जाना चाहिए इट्स नॉट अ नॉन कंप्लायंस आई एग्री विद यू इट्स समथिंग वी कैन फाइट फॉर बट इफ यू से हेल्पलाइन लगाओ ताकि क्लाइंट को फोन करिए मतलब क्या है
सर, बात नहीं करना सर, आप एक मिनट डीएससी रहने से बाहर जाकर ऑल ओवर इंडिया बेसिस पर सेमिनार्स करते हैं कि लीडरशिप पे एजुकेट करने के लिए
करते हैं
ना सर, जो जो जिसके यहाँ कोई फंक्शन था किसी ने अटेंड नहीं किया वो तो बेचारा अनएजुकेटेड रह गया
सर। यस एक्चुअली इज ऑन आवर साइड, खाली खाली टाइम पास कर रहे हैं
सर, मैं टाइम पास नहीं कर रहा हूँ सर,
बिल्कुल कर
रहे हैं। एनएससी आईपीएफ और बीएससी आईपीएफ, दे आर एजुकेटिंग द कस्टमर्स के डू दिस डोंट डू दिस डू दिस, अल्टीमेटली दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड बिकॉज दे आर ओनली इंटरेस्टेड इन आइदर बाइंग और सेलिंग, और वो इंस्ट्रक्शन बुक्स ऑल्सो आर विद द ब्रोकर्स आई थिंक
व्हिच इज इलीगल। Really, I would say in this seminar, we need how to simplify our compliances. Could we have something where it has gone on a concurrent basis? I don't have to submit to the exchange. Mera client balance exchange wants every month this date, it has to ask randomly a trial balance of whatever broker. They want to know the fund position, someone asks the broker is defaulting or not. We should have a I'm telling you, this is just go to Abu Dhabi Financial Exchange. It's an Abu Dhabi exchange. First of all, the broker doesn't have the right to open an account. The accounts are opened at a centralized account opening system, which is Abu Dhabi Financial Exchange. That is the exchange of Abu Dhabi Stock Exchange. So one thing,
I will come to one very clear thing. The exchange as well as the BSE brokers forum should do only one thing, get the brokers out of compliance. Maybe we have to comply, we are not saying we don't want to comply, but make it concurrent, like say contract notes are going, BSE has got a system where you can send it through some BSE system, NSE has got, let everybody follow, so the contract part is over. The compliance of language and all. Centralized BSE should say this is the standard KYC. I am saying 20 brokers, 20 different KYCs with some clause which is again non-compliant with the exchange. Why? This is the compliance, means the KYC has to be this way. Font size or whatever. There is lot of, because when they are coming to audit us now, every auditor is using his own brains. Rather than the circular in spirit, no doubt they are helping us, but somewhere we are failing.
And one guarantee that this form will not be changed for the next 5 years.
No, it can change.
It is an online.
I would say rather it's an online form. Aap download nahi karna hai. Put in your customer's name, address, few things. It gets printed. We should not be even printing the forms and wasting 10,000 printing forms goes down the
in Ratiwala. In fact. The last week when we had this forum board meeting,
I'm
sorry, we discussed that can there be something like a centralized back office?
BSE has got it, I think so.
But again, we also, like a managed service provider, that you have to do काम खत्म, trade file बनेगा, contract note जाएगा, सब कुछ जाएगा, तो खाली payment का चिंता करो.
You mean to say, it's an outsourced service basically. Who is ready to invest?
फिर compliance खत्म हो जाए फिर अपने धंधे के बारे में नहीं ठीक है ऐसे कई तरह ऐसे कई तरह के आइडियाज हमें सोचना पड़ेगा
सर। मैं आपको एक चीज कहना चाहूंगा,
ये काम एक्सचेंज का नहीं है,
ये अपना है,
ये काम अपना है। कंप्लायंस सेमिनार नहीं, बिजनेस डेवलपमेंट सेमिनार में सब डिस्कस होना चाहिए, बट एक बार कंप्लायंस के इश्यूज हो जाए, लेट्स कॉल दिस मीटिंग फॉर्मली क्लोज, देन वी कैन एक्चुअली कंटिन्यू दिस to discuss more business ideas. I mean, as in, सब लोग हर आपके अपने ऑफिस में सेम चीज कर रहे हैं यार, एक एक ही जगह हो तो अपने सब कितने 3:30 बजे दूसरे धंधे में धंधा एक्सपांशन में सोचे ताकि कंप्लायंस
करें।
3:30 के बाद का सर, 3:30 के बाद का दूसरा धंधा तो ढूंढ रही है सर। in the same premises 2002 or 2003 ke andar SafeGate made it to come out with this one PAN number. In the same premises Mr. Dilip Pope was handling the seminar, handful of people was there, and I suggested him at that time, why don't you come out with this single system? That's what he said in Abu Dhabi. And the same thing is 10 years or 12 years for the SEBI to come with a complex KRA system. We were, that is not a single thing. If exchange is not doing anything, like when exchange is registering, when we register, when KRA register, then there is a requirement. If they are not registered in 60 days, then you cannot trade for him. And starting keto, backlog was there. We got a not we got a reprimand from the NSE or something. That is second thing. But the thing is what you said right now. कि KYC होना चाहिए, बैक ऑफिस होनी चाहिए. सर बैक ऑफिस के अंदर एक प्रॉब्लम आ जाएगा, क्योंकि हर एक अपना अपना प्रॉब्लम है. वो आप कह रहे डिस्कस करने का तो 10 साल लगेगा उसके लिए.
ये सेशन दिया माना नया सेशन फर्क हो गया और सेशन सुनते जाएंगे कि किसी दिन कुछ रेलवे कोई आएगा कोई स्टार्टअप शुरू होगा आपके बीच. Any compliance-related query, specifically...
Sir, PML-related seminar is required, changes every year.
PML?
PML, related to PML, what the exchange really wants. Exchange has PML mein kuch aisa specific inspection mein kiya nahi hai. Specific regarding exchange, some 1, 2, 3 point kabhi koi dekh leta hai. Kuch aga, even only in the case ki books mein koi problems hai toh, otherwise dekhega bhi nahi ho. So basically what we want is, इतने साल हो गए 14 साल के एक सिंगल तो पीएल में करना.
ओके
थैंक यू
द ब्रोकर कैन क्लोज द अकाउंट ऑफ द क्लाइंट सो इन यूसीसी बाय मेकिंग इट इनएक्टिव इज इक्वल टू क्लोजर ऑफ द अकाउंट
नो इन द यूसीसी डेटाबेस इफ यू मेक इट इनएक्टिव It is not linked with the trading.
My question, I repeat, suppose I want to close Mr. A's account, who is my client, what should I do?
See, in exchange UCC database, you have to change the status to inactive. Then, but there is no, it is not linked with the trading. It is not that. It will be considered unregistered if you trade later on with that client.
Sir, aap samjhao na simple language mein.
Bazaar ke language mein. Main ye bol rahi ki jab bhi koi client call hota hai, usko inactive kar lete hain. UCC mein inactive karna. Lekin galti se usme trade ho bhi gaya baad mein, to 10,000 penalty bhi lagegi. Bas ye ulta advantage bol rahe. अब इनेक्टिव कर लिया फिर अचानक उठ के सौदा कर लो कर लो कर लो यूसीसी अपने देश में प्रॉब्लम है ना पुराना क्लाइंट है यूसीसी वो है किसने इनेक्टिव किया किसी को ध्यान नहीं है सॉरी सॉरी सर वो कर सकते डीरेल मत करो सो पेनल्टी नहीं लगाएगा बट देन इनएक्टिव क्लाइंट सौदा कर रहा है वो अपने आप में एक
What I understood from your talk is that if I want to close the account of Mr. A, I should make it inactive in UCC. Now tomorrow, if he completes the formalities that I have to make him active, just go back, revert, and make it.
You can still just inactive transaction.
No, but what he means, he wants to close the account of the client. So tomorrow, by any other employee of the company,
should not be able to trade in that account.
See,
what does the account close means? That there is no transaction in future.
So there are two things. अपने office में front office होता है, back office होता है. Front office मतलब now, FAO, TWCO. Back office होता है UCC क्या load किया ये. अब front office में कौन से code सौदा कर सकता है वो अपने नक्की करते हैं. यारे मैंने यहाँ पे 25 पिछले 25 साल से मेरा firm चल रहा है 25,000 client code loaded है. ठीक है जो मतलब code loaded है UCC allotted है. उसमें से करीब 3,000 active है. बाकी वो इनएक्टिव बाकी है लेकिन फ्रंट ऑफिस में 3,000 के अलावा 3,000 एक में सौदा नहीं हो वो ध्यान रखना अपना काम है फिर भी किसी ने कर दिया देन इट्स अ ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ द सिस्टम्स इन योर ऑफिस व्हाट कैन एक्सचेंज डू अबाउट इट एक्सचेंज इज गिवन ऑप्शन इनएक्टिव मार्क कर दो एक्सचेंज इज गिवन द ऑप्शन इनएक्टिव एक्टिव करना तो कर सकते चलो यार अब हमें प्रॉब्लम है कि हमने ऑप्शन क्यों दिया अब हम पे पेनल्टी क्यों नहीं लगाते तो ये तो कोई पॉइंट नहीं है
सर एक question last week I faced. I asked one of my client, I don't know do your trades. I felt something fishy. So मैंने उसको बोल दिया कि मैं I don't know do your trades. Client बोलता मुझे आपका अकाउंट बंद नहीं करना है, मुझे चालू ही रखना है. Can he do? I've stopped his trading. Can he do take any action against me through the?
Under rights and obligation form पड़ा है, नया वाला. सेबी राइट्स एंड ऑब्लिगेशन पॉइंट नंबर 28 है या पॉइंट नंबर 17 होगा, सब कुछ है. डीपी का भी है, ब्रोकी का भी है. व्हेन यू हैव अ राइट टू क्लोज द अकाउंट फॉर एनी रीजन, बट ऑल यू हैव टू डू इज गिव अ 30 डेज नोटिस.
इफ आई एम फिशिंग इज डूइंग सर्कुलर ट्रेडिंग देन
बोले काइंडली नोट दैट एज पर द इंटरनल पॉलिसीज ऑफ ऑफिस योर अकाउंट विद अस इज टर्मिनेटेड. This is a 30-day notice under point number so and so of the rules and rights.
Land account open के 15 दिन हुआ था.
Sorry.
Land account open के 15 दिन हुआ
था. 30 days का दिन है.
15 days का नोट उसका काम कर रहा है.
अरे बाबू
अपना वो आएगा नहीं.
अब तो उसको closure का notice दे दिया, 30 दिन में खाता बंद कर सकते हो. वो बोले नहीं, अब तो मुझे इस 30 दिन तक तो मुझे सौदा करना ही है, तुम रोक नहीं सकते. ये आप बोल रहे हो ना?
वो तो सब हो गया.
मुझे खाता बंद करना है, आप उसको 30 डेज का नोटिस दो, कितना खाता बंद. वो 30 डेज तक बोलेगा तुमको मेरे सौदा करना ही पड़ेगा, क्या आप बोल सकते हो मैं नहीं करता जा. Is that a question? That's a question.
Yes, sir.
I think you can refuse any trade which does not fall under the risk management policy or any policy of your office, as long as that policy is in public domain. If you put a policy on a website, okay, every trade is vetted by me, and if any trade doesn't meet our surveillance guidelines, whatever guidelines you want to call, we refuse those trades. As long as you have such a policy which you have declared to the world at large, then you can stop. You cannot be random.